That had not been a nightmare. I was awake. For certain. It was a hallucination. A hallucination like those described by Faber in his letter, shortly before hanging himself from a beam in his office. A hallucination. Or something worse. Much worse. Had it done any good to return the music box to its owner? Husha might have the answer, but his whereabouts was still unknown. And his trail seemed to have gone cold as the days passed by. Perhaps in his office, somewhere in his papers. Among the documents he was researching while delving into the box's origins. Maybe there would be some clue in there as to where he had gone or what he had done. Something that would help us to follow his footsteps. I had to find Sebastian Husha. But this time, my life depended on it. Grace, a PhD student and Husha's mentee, and Professor Nasiri, one of his associates, gladly agreed to give us a hand with the search. They used to stay up late working in Husha's office, so that seemed like a good place to start.
We had no idea how serious the situation was. If we'd known about his family, those poor children.
I hope we can at least find out what exactly he was after and where he went.
There are some papers on his desk that haven't been touched since he left. We have a good chance of finding something there.
Lately, I feel like something odd has gotten into Professor Husher. I mean, apart from his usual oddities. He seemed anxious about something and looked like he hadn't slept properly in days. No offense, Mr. Nora, but it looks like it's the same for you.
Don't worry, none taken. I'm well aware.
This is his desk. As you can see, there are a bunch of documents he uses as research for his novels.
It's all here. We better take a look at his computer and the shelves, too. The sooner we get started, the sooner we'll find something out. Look at this here. There are some notes where he mentions the music box, but I can't quite understand what he means. AA375 is underlined.
AA, that's how the documents in the Donations and Biographies archive are designated. Maybe he was looking for something there.
Biographies. Let's start with the archive, then. Where is it?
Donations and biographies are on the basement level. I'm sure it will be closed, but we can easily find the janitor or a key. It's not a very busy area. Let me go. I know the place. You keep searching this area. This place. There's something in the atmosphere. Something evil. Merino. He's always the same. That man needs a therapist.
Thank you.
Saving me.
Hmm. Oh.
Thank you.
Oh my.
It's been a while now. Should we go see if everything's okay?
I bet he got wrapped up reading something. I'll go check. Remember this place being so scary.
Not just that, there was someone in there,
holding the release lever. It was me. I was in there. I pulled the cable, took the slides, and got the hell out of there. Laugh all you want, but now... I'm scared to go back downstairs.
To keep this lever pressed down if I want to get into the archive. Okay, I got this working. Let's see. Thank you. door? What is it doing there?
I can't believe it. Is this real? Where am I? I'm gonna throw up. What have I done? I can't believe this is happening.
can't find anything. This might have something to do with Husher's investigation.
Let's see. It's a book about Argos Legrand. A biography or a collection of articles about him, I think. He apparently spent part of his life traveling the world in search of odd, rare events. Rich people stuff. I don't know. The biography suddenly ends right after his last journey. It says here, he returned without his equipment, without the huge amount of money he wasted on the project. And with the simple memory of the music he brought home to his little girls, 8-year-old Elaine and newborn Ariadne. And here's a note from Hasha that says, "See the archives, events newspaper." Is there a newspaper archive over here?